All right, that'll do. Let's play Hayate. Let's do this because I feel like it. But no, Iona Vampire Deuce, I quite like her. She's really a good ship. You can get a lot of good work out of a Vampire Deuce once you spend a little time. If you know Haida and you like Haida and you understand how to play Haida, all of the same lessons apply to Vampire Deuce, and you can get really good work out of the ship. The one big drawback is when you go from tier 7 Haida matchmaking up to tier 10, you're going to see a lot more radar. So you just have to plan for that. Know that going in. Speaking of Vampire Deuce, and then we got Kleber, Shima, Yugumo, and their team. So, yeah. So, everybody, the Kleber, I outspot the Kleber. I can avoid that engagement. The Shima and the Yugumo outspot me by about a half a kilometer, which hurts. They have two radar, but I have lots of squishy battleships to throw torpedoes at, so that feels good. I do not XTC. I do not. I could buy it. I've got the doubloons, but I don't have it. The lacquer camo for this ship is stunning, but they're incredibly proud of it. So... again, it's one of those things that I find I can't truly recommend because of that, right?
You're crazy, son.
Warspeed with the resub. Thank you so much. The camo is stunning, but they're incredibly proud of it. And Hayate is a very mixed bag ship. You're talking about investing 2 million free XP and 8,000 doubloons. It's like 8,000 doubloons, isn't it? Yeah, I cannot recommend that. If you've got money to burn, you got nothing else to spend it on, hey, you do you, buddy. It's your money. It's not my place to say. But if you're playing warships on a budget, I cannot recommend that. I thought it was 8K, Chiron. Maybe it's 5K. Either way, if it's 5K, it's a little more tolerable, but still, like, yikes. That's a lot of doubloons, right? Kyle, I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that. All right, let's see. I'm going to be here spotting. I've got two radars behind me. I'm going to try and put some torps in behind this island. Presumably somebody will try to get sneaky and go in over there. I don't remember either, Kyle, but like you, I remember hearing about it somewhere. Yep, somebody's in this cap. If it's anybody but the Kleber, I will not be able to outspot them. They left the cap. That's curious. Back in the cap now. Some funky crap going on here, kids. All right, so the Alaska's existence in this position means I cannot move up and contest the cap. Not really. However, I could maybe get a little cheeky and force him to burn a radar for no gain. Let's try it. Because I can put my butt into the cap where he won't have a shot, won't have a good shot on me at all. Kleber's on the flank, so I know I'm dealing with the Shima or the Yugumo. That's fine. I'm not RPF'd. That's also good. I'm going to get just enough of my ship into this cap circle to start capping. That will draw out the radar from the Alaska. They'll know where I am, but the Alaska will have no shots. Not from where he's at. Then we'll push out on the flank.
You're crazy, son of a bitch. You're dead.
Then we'll push out on the flank and start working on the Vanguard with torpedoes. I'm surprised he's not radaring me. Okay. Mr. October with the gifted subs. Look at that. Thank you so much. Welcome. Appreciate you, sir. Do I know when King of the Sea? Yeah, it's announced already. 9 Saturday, the 9th of October, will be the first day of King of the Sea here on NA. Signups are open right now. All that's happening right now, go have fun. That Vanguard is going to die before I can go over there. Okay. Hi, Yugumo. How you doing, buddy? Once I finish capping, I might throw some shells at you. Alas, not meant to be. All right, so we got the cap. We already have a 3-ship lead? What the hell is this team doing? Whatever. Adeldro with the bits! Thanks, Adeldro. Appreciate you. All right, what is this George doing? He's stopping. Shima's way up through mid. I'm never going to get Torps on the Georgia. Let's go get in a gunfight with the Shima and wipe him out. Thank you for the hype train, gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, excuse me. Thank you for the hype train, everyone. Let's leave it at that. Let's go over here and kill this Shima. He annoys me. He deserves to die. Shima can outsmart me, but he cannot outgun me. I will absolutely win a gunfight with this guy if it comes to that. Okay, he got the Jutland. Now he's trying to smoke and hide. I've just the thing for you, sir. You're going to love them. They're called torpedoes. Here, hold my ammo. Whoa! Desert Eagle with the big bits. Thank you so much. Appreciate that. Thank you kindly. All right, let's go Shima hunting. Let's see if we can find this guy. Adegi, the team on the Aflink is doing a great job of focusing out targets, so kudos to them. All right, now this is going to be a struggle because I'm going to stumble across this guy at point-blank range. He's going to have at least one of his torpedo racks reloaded, more than likely. So I've got to be very, very cautious of how I play this, or I'm going to find myself dead. Okay, so he left this smoke. He's not... There he is. Okay, I'm going to have cover from the Alaska, which will be good. Let's focus on killing the Shimakaze. Hetman with the bits! Thank you!
Oh, and it got such good gas mileage.
Yep, Amagi's dead. But, for his many sins, I will be able to kill the Shimakaze. I know your smoke is down, sir. So, you will be going off the board here. Thank you. We'll get flipped. So I can avoid the Alaska's guns. We'll keep this island in between me and the Alaska. And everybody will go home happy. Chopping block for removal. I think Ragnar's already on the short list. Personal opinion. If you can get a Ragnar, get one now. Don't wait. That ship is stupid, and I don't think she's gonna survive in her current form in the shop for very long. I don't think she can. She's gross. So, yeah, if you can get a Ragnar, pick one up now. Thank you, Kyle. Beyond that, I don't really know what else is out there. I'm a little surprised FDR is still for sale, if you want my personal opinion. I feel like that ship needs... I realize Ragnar hasn't been out that long, but the ship is just gross. It's gross. I'm telling you, that's going to be one of the next things. That's going to be one of the next ships to go. I'm telling you right now, it's coming. It's going to happen. Fair edge case. I don't know. I just feel like Ragnar's got to be on somebody's hit list already. That ship is just disgusting and gross. Two hits? Only two hits? Feels bad. Two hits and a flood. I'll take that. Who did this? Who the freak ate my... Still flooding. Something is still flooding. Let's get out of here. Speed up. I presume it's the Thunderer, but I don't know for a fact. Yeah, the thunder is sitting on a flood. No, he put it out now. Always did have more balls than brains, O'Connell. All right. Fair enough, Thunder. We'll play it your way. But I don't think you're going to like what happens next. Alaska's radar is absolutely down. And the Thunder is coming into my trap. So this will be fun. Let's use these guns to farm something, shall we? Let's farm the squishy Thunderer. He magically found a hole in my torpedo salvo. I'm super excited about this. Why won't you die? Thank you. I'm tempted to just sail up and annihilate the Alaska with my torps. Not like I want to get in a gunfight with him. Which way your gun's looking, sir? That's a problem. Of course, I slowed down right into it.
I'm gonna feel that one in the morning.
Interesting, he's not shooting at me. And he's about to ground himself. Okay. Sure.
Oh, lucky shot. Damn, desert road, no gas, and no chicks. Much better.
All right, next, Rune and Yugamo. Yugamo's in the cap. I can beat that guy in a gunfight. Let's go do it. So, differences between Friesland and Ragnar. I mean, Friesland and... So, I've got a video on Ragnar on my channel that if you're interested, you should watch, because I kind of talk through a lot of this stuff. Ragnar's a cat bully. She really is a cat bully. You div that thing up with another ship, and it's just obscene what she can do. The guns, the armor is what will throw off most destroyers, right? Like Elbing, she has extra armor amidships, which means that most destroyer HE will shatter on her hull. So you have to fire AP at the thing if you want to kill it. Hang on a minute. Throw my guns in here. Oh, he's turning in. Are you turning in? Okay. Well, we can do that. Never mind. Mine says get wrecked. She has no torpedoes. She has no smoke. She has a heal, a stupidly fast speed boost. She has that same emergency engine power thing that Smallin does. And then she has 7.5 kilometer radar. 7.5 kilometer radar matches her detection circle. So that's really handy. Ragnar's just a really, really good package. She works best. Wait, the game we saw earlier, right? The Ragnar, okay, so the game we played earlier in Grozovoy, the Ragnar and the gearing, separately, are less effective than they are together, okay? Because what they were doing correctly, they weren't even did together, they were just doing this. The gearing would play forward and spot for him, and then the Ragnar can play back and pew-pew all the things, because that's what Ragnar does. And so... the gearing, basically, in that instance, that's why I knew once I killed the gearing, I was going to be able to, I can't push the Ragnar, but if I can kill his spotter, if I can kill the gearing, I can get into a gunfight with a Ragnar if I have backup. Me versus the Ragnar solo, probably not a good idea, because he has 6-inch guns. That's the other thing, right? Ragnar basically has light cruiser guns and light cruiser health on a destroyer package, But those guns have like a 2.5-second reload, 3-second reload, something like that. It's really... Gearing has a reinforced midsection of 21 millimeters. There's a reason I was firing AP at the gearing as well, okay? But it's not as good as Ragnar's 25 millimeters. There are some cruisers in the game that will struggle to pin a Ragnar amidships with HE, right? Like a Smolensk... Smolensk can do it. Yeah. 180... No, 130s. No, she can't. 130 divided by 6? 23? Yeah. So a Smolensk's HE shells cannot pen a broadside Ragnar. She has too much armor. So if you're like a Grozovoy, right? If I'm in a Grozovoy, I can't pen him amidships. Whereas I can pen a gearing. So it's Ragnar has all the advantages to crush opposing destroyers in 1v1 gunfights with them. Again, between the health and everything else, it's just silly what that ship is capable of. Druid, and as Edgecase points out, Druid is a tiny Minotaur. She fires only AP. All of her guns are forward. She has a decent chunk of health. It looks like an interesting ship. I've not played it at all.
You crazy son of a bitch, you're dead.
Just try not to cough. I failed. But yes, Nolo. Yes. Druid is basically a bow tanking destroyer. She just drives her bow at the enemy, pew pews them until they're dead. Is Ragnar allowed in COTS? I believe so. But I will say that I'm not. As much as I like Ragnar, I'm not convinced she's going to be meta-defining or, like, game-breaking or anything like this. She is a ship that functions best in groups or divisions, in my opinion. But I also know, knowing King of the Sea the way I do, I feel like teams, you know, let's assume you for a minute, you came in with a plan to deal with a Smallland, right? Then, you can basically adapt that same plan to deal with the Ragnar. It's basically the same kind of idea. Man, Artillery Cruisers kicked ass. Good for those guys. Missouri had a good game. That whole flank on my left had a good game. Seattle over there played a good game. Yeah, that worked out. That's one of the first games that I was like, yeah, that's a decent little team win there. We kind of, everybody pitched in. Okay, so both torps went into the Thunder. Okay, and then he took a flood.